guys, it's Sam from Nonfiction Horror, and today's video is going to be books I read when I was little that made me love horror and scary books today. So I can hands down say the exact moment when I knew that I loved scary stories, scary books, and that this was something I actually felt that I loved and that I wanted to know more about, and that I felt like it just, there was a little bing, little light bulb went off in my brain that said, hey, this is cool. I like this. What is this whole genre that I didn't even know? I like being scared. It's kind of weird being scared, but I love it. What is it? So I can attribute that feeling and that love for everything kind of scary and dark to this book, which is In a Dark, Dark Room by Alvin Schwartz. So I remember reading this when I was very little. I had to be less than 7, maybe older than 4, somewhere around there. And I stumbled across this book. I honestly don't remember if we bought it or if it was just lying around in the house. I don't remember how we got this book, but nonetheless, I read it and I fell in love. And there is one story in this book that I can say the moment when I read the very last sentence on the last page, something clicked inside my brain. It was just like, this is awesome. I love it, because I had no idea that this was going to happen in the story. So I was totally blindsided. And so let me show you what that story is. This is actually the original. And then here is the updated version, which I just gotta say, this is meant for preschool in grade 1. So this was meant, I guess the reading level obviously is for preschool to first grade, but this content I think would be a little bit kind of morbid for a first grader to read. So that alone, I would say this would be good for maybe like fourth grade, just because I think at that age you really can't tell, like, oh, is this real or not? Like, you can't really understand what's going on. And so I think that's why at a young age people do start having fears of ghosts and the boogeyman, because if you're reading something this young, your brain can't really wrap around that it's not real. So I would definitely say that these books were a little bit maybe scary for me to be reading at my age, but nonetheless, the story I am referring to, sorry for that delay, is The Green Ribbon. So if you don't know what this is about, which you might be seeing memes around, I feel like there's kind of a comeback of the story. It's a cult classic, I would say. Maybe if you're a 90s kid, you read this book, and so you know what I'm talking about. But if you don't, what the story is this girl right here, Jenny, and pretty much since she was young, she's always worn a green ribbon around her neck. And so at first, you know, it's not a big deal, but then Jenny started growing up and boys got involved and she started dating, and so her boyfriend Alfred was like, hey Jenny, what's that on your neck? And she's like, don't worry about it, it's not a big deal, it's okay. But then, you know, they're getting married, things are getting serious now, and then as you see, they've been together, they lived a long happy life, but she starts to get really ill. And so you can still see she's all, I mean, look at her fingers. Can we just talk about like how decrepit and scary she looks? Anyway, so Alfred's like, Jenny, just tell me, why? What's on your neck? And then in the very last page, you see her head has fallen off. And so for me, being so young and then seeing this, it's really frightening. Honestly, you're like, her head fell off? And I totally didn't see it coming. I can honestly say I'm really bad at guessing who the person is, like Scooby-Doo. I could never guess who it is. Even to this day, I'm like, oh my God, who could it be? I'm totally blindsided at the end. So maybe that's just me, but I totally didn't know her head was gonna fall off, even though I kinda could see where the story was going. But anyways, at that moment, half of me was totally like torn. This is awesome, this is really cool. And like, ooh, that's so weird and morbid, but I love it. What is this? What's this feeling that I have? I want more of this. So that was definitely the moment where I think today, now being 27, it did impact me all these years later, and now I love scary movies, scary songs, scary books, scary shows. I just love it. So, great series by Alvin Schwartz, and if you can see, there's going to be a common denominator that Alvin Schwartz had a huge impact in my life, so just shout out to him. I don't even know if he's still alive, that's horrible, but great author. So, next we have none other than scary stories to tell in the dark. So I would say this was kind of like the next stage when I was growing up. I was kind of reading a little bit more in-depth chapter books at this point. So this is kind of where I was going to next and reading these. And so these were a big hit in my family. We all read them and we absolutely loved them. I do say that my family on my mom's side were really into scary movies. We used to watch them when we were little. We used to like to scare each other, me and my cousin, or we would go to movies and we'd all watch scary movies. So yeah. Let's just get started on the ones that impacted me. I wouldn't say necessarily that there was a story that stood out like the In a Dark, Dark Room book with the green ribbon, but I would say it was the images that were implanted in my brain, that they're just etched in there, that when I think of these books, I automatically think of the illustrator, who is Stephen Gamble. Yes, and he created pretty much all the artwork. And I was really sad when I knew that they had I don't want to say remastered, but they re-illustrated and do new additions to this book. So I was super bummed out because that's totally what made the series, was the artwork. And I'm pretty sure I've been hearing rumored around that they're making this a real life movie, which, oh my gosh, can I just say, I don't even care if it's horrible, I'm gonna love it. So let's start with just, for example, one of the images I do like in more scary stories to tell in the dark, which not as good as the original, but of course, you know, I still loved it. But I just absolutely loved how dark and scary these images were. Like, they were really demented and just, I mean, any of them. I mean, I can flip to any page and they're just scary. Dark, that I feel like if you had some of this artwork in your house, people would definitely get some creep vibes from you and they would kind of see like, okay, this girl's into some dark shit. That's cool. She's into some dark stuff. I understand. But the one that I absolutely love, which I wouldn't mind having this poster sized on my wall, at one point I was kind of playing with the idea of getting this tattooed on me, but I don't know, I just feel like it's great in theory, but I think to walk around with this might be like a little bit too frightening. But this girl right here, I absolutely love this image, and I think this embodies the whole more scary stories to tell in the dark and the whole series in general. This just sums up the series. And so I would say you've definitely probably seen this if you've read any of those books in the scary stories. I believe there's a three set. There's a set of three. So between these books together that I've shown you, that definitely just kind of set me off into kind of just this whole genre that I absolutely adore and I have such a love for, because not many people like to be scared or talk about scary things, or nobody really likes to be scared, but I actively seek out being kind of just unnerved a little bit and being kind of just, it's just off, or it's morbid or a little bit more macabre. That's totally what I just absolutely love. There's really no explanation for it. It just happened. Just sometimes when you start growing up, things get, you know, piled onto your personality, and that was just one of those things that I attributed to just starting at a young age, and that's who I am now. So I would like to give some honorable mentions, of course, to other books that I absolutely adored when I grew up, and that would be Goosebumps by R.L. Stein. That was a great series, specifically The Haunted Mask. I used to watch that every Halloween, and every now and then I try to find it on Netflix or on the internet and watch it, and that's the one where she goes into the costume store. Everybody thinks she's a big wuss, so she wants, everybody thinks she's like a big sissy. Big wuss, so she ends up getting this really scary mask, which ends up getting attached to her and she can't take it off. And I just remember her demon voice being really scary. I just really freaked me out, honestly. All those stories really, like I said, were my childhood favorites. I would like you guys to post down below, what did you guys read when you were little? What book made an impact on you? And did that make any impression on you? Do you actually hate scary stories now because you were so terrified when you were little that now you just kind of stay away from the whole genre in general? So thank you guys for watching. Bye.